Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Trender Center for today's ODAC Championship first round contest between the 6th-seeded Hornets of Shenandoah University and the 3rd-seeded Virginia Wesleyan University Marlins. Before today's match, the ODAC would like to remind you that it promotes good sportsmanship by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner. Profanity, racial, or sexist comments, or other intimidating actions directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or team representatives will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal from the site of competition. Also, consumption or possession of alcoholic beverages is prohibited. Let's begin with lineups. First, for the visiting Hornets, starting at midfield, number 7, Abby Alexa. Starting at midfield, number 9, Kristen Fisher. Starting at forward, number 10, Emily Juergen. Starting at forward, number 11, Sarah Sonic. Starting at midfield, number 14, Allison Spaziani. Starting at forward, number 18, Maya Pensil. Starting at defense, number 19, Taylor Morris. Starting at defense, number 20, Abby Marquette. Starting at defense, number 21, Travia Morris. Starting at midfield, number 30, Bella Infuso. And in goal for the Hornets, number 99, Emily Smith. The Hornets are coached by Elizabeth Pike. She's assisted by Aaron Scepter, Haley Etchard, L.A. St. Hill, Des Lawless, and Joel Flower. And now, the starting lineup for your Virginia Wesleyan University Marlins. Starting at forward, number 10, Anna Petticone. Starting at defense, number 13, Shea Geary. Starting at forward, number 15, Allie Fitz. Starting at forward, number 19, Mia Meinhardt. Starting at midfield, number 20, Kennedy Anders. Starting at midfield, number 21, Mary Alexis Jackson. Starting at forward, number 22, Reyna Arujo. Starting at defense, number 23, Sam Crawford. Starting at forward, number 28, Taya Lorenzi. Starting at defense, number 30, Abby Peterson. And in goal for the Marlins, number 1, Amruta Kakar. The Marlins are coached by Jeff Bowers. He's assisted by Pat Corbett, Mario Hurdle, and Vassett Leidy. Now we ask you all stand and remove your caps as we honor a great country with the playing of our national anthem.
Yeah, pump it up, yeah, pump it, baby. Free kick, Shenandoah. Shenandoah appears to be putting this ball forward by throwing most of their players towards the Marlins box. Marlins are matched up man for man defending this kick with Shea Geary floating as a free player as she drops in. Shea Geary goes up for the header. The Shenandoah player winning it, flicking it on past Plast and Ruta Kakar in goal. Freshman Amruta Kakar is making her ninth career start today. She currently has a goals against average of .56. Very respectable for a freshman. Jackson looks to clear it up the field, where it's deflected out for a Marlins throw-in. Pettacone on the throw to Arujo. Crosses the ball into the mix. Cleared away by Shenandoah, out for a Marlins throw. Pettacone looking to take the throw. Finds Mihard on the ball. Looks to cross it into Fitz and cleared away by Shenandoah. Good bit of pressure for the Marlins to open here. Hopefully they can find the ball and capitalize on a quick play soon. Good clearance by Shen. Good knockdown. Who looks to go big quickly. Chased down by their number 10, Jurgen. Great pressure on the ball. Coming into today's match, Jurgen, number 10 for the Shenandoah Hornets, has 13 goals this season, and 61 career goals. It's her 71st start today. The Rookie of the Year in 2016 and a three-time first-team All-ODAC player, certainly someone to keep an eye on. I'm sure the Marlins have her in the scouting report today. Shenandoah throw-in on the far, down their high left flank for them. Throws it in short, looking to get the ball back to the thrower. Good battle on the flank between Marquette and Arujo. Mihard is on the ball right now for the Marlins, looking to connect the pass. She's able to find Fitz in the midfield, who plays it back. Nice little 1-2 here. Gets pushed off the ball by number 14. Great defensive play by Spinizzi. Clearance by the Marlins center back. Taylor Renzi putting the pressure on by the Marlins to keep the ball in. Forced the clearance, Fitz flicks it on. Lorenzi with a bit of pressure. Cleared out to Pensil for the Hornets. Takes a bit of a big touch, and Geary is able to come in with the clearance. Lorenzi shielding off the ball, is able to find Fitz, who pokes it along to the Shenandoah outside back, Marquette. Marquette with the big ball, putting Geary under pressure. Morris is able to get enough. Finds Arujo up the flank, who passes to no one. There was a bit of room for Fitz to run into, but the two are not on the same page. Good step by Pettacone, looking to slip her in on the one touch. She appears to be onside. Good goalkeeping by Smith to come out and collect the ball. Smith jogs over with the ball in her hands to the top right of her box, looking to go big on this play. Good contest in the midfield for a Shenandoah throw. Off Fitz. Peterson contesting. Good turn by Spinizzi in the midfield. Able to link up with number 7, Alexa. Crawford clears the ball away. Fitz in possession. finds Mihart. Oh, and a great build by the Virginia Wesleyan Marlins, but Reyna Arojo unable to finish in front. They may look back and regret not being able to finish that one. Great ball across from Mihart. Big kick from goalkeeper Smith. The ball is won by Kennedy Anders, out for a Shenandoah throw-in. Fits on the ball. Looks to play Arujo, but is intercepted by Sarasonic. Great defensive work, who finds Morris on the left flank. Shea Geary going back to collect the ball as pressure from both sides. Chooses to release, and a good clearance to Arojo.
Arojo.
Petticone on the ball for the throw-in, for the Marlins throw-in. Looking to find some options, chooses to go down the flank. Gets the ball to me in my heart. Shenandoah whistled for the foul and it will be a free kick for the Marlins. Free kick looks to be about 21, 22 yards out against the sideline. Kennedy Anders will be on the ball. Looking to take the ball right-footed, so it will be an out-swinging ball. Shenandoah is setting a two-player wall. Protect that near post. Force the Marlins to cross the ball in. Eliminate that shot. We'll see if the Marlins can get on the end of it. Appears to be a lot of space in the front of the box. Ball into the box. Goalkeeper comes. Great job collecting it by Smith. Fantastic goalkeeping out of the sophomore. Smith looks to go big again. Target looks to be Jurgen. Ball in the air. Jurgen wins the knockdown. Finds number 14, Spinisi. Spicini looks to clip the ball down the sideline. Goes out of bounds. Marlins throwing. Lorenzi has the ball. Looking to finds our forward partner, Mihart. Cleared out for a Marlins throw. Mihart looking to get a corner, unable to knock it off the Shenandoah player, who clears the ball long. Good win by Peterson to keep them under pressure. Mihart drives and is unable to turn the corner, but is able to put enough pressure to get a throw in. An early sub by the Virginia Wesleyan Marlins. And that'll be Alex Fitz will be coming out of the match, and featuring in will be
in the game for the Marlins, number 32, Allie Angel.
Allie Angel has entered the match in the midfield for the Marlins. Looking to get an early touch. Hornets looking to clear. Gets the ball to half, but Shea Geary is on it. Keeps it in. Angel's first touch of the mass. Is able to link up with Kennedy Anders. Torrey Morris on the ball for the Hornets. Plays Alexa. Alexa streaking down the sideline. Gets muscled out. Fantastic defense by Crawford. Crawford looking to release Reyna Arojo. Arojo, excuse me. Ball slipped in. Again, quick offer line, Emily Smith, to clean up anything in front of the box. Emily Smith with the punt. Ball goes to about half field, where Jurgen is able to win the knockdown. Pensil looks to clear it up the line. Deflected out, but it will remain a Hornets throw-in. Jurgen on the ball. Throws it down the sideline, putting the Marlins under pressure. Alexa is chasing it down. Has a chance to cross it in. Appeared to be a handball, but no call. That's a goal, Hornets. Ball crossed into the box, knocked down, finished quickly by number, and the Marlins start the kickoff.
Hornets goal scored by number 14, Allison Spaziani.
As you just heard, Allison Spaziani is credited with that goal. Pretty much against the run of play. Marlins have had in the first 15 minutes, Marlins have had more of the ball in the Hornets' end. But what matters is the scoreboard. And right now it's Hornets 1, Marlins 0. Lorenzi looks to drive at and is able to win a corner kick. Marlins looking to answer quickly. Corner kick from the left side. Kennedy Anders will be on the ball. Kennedy took the free kick that happened about 5 minutes ago. Hit a good ball into the box, but great goalkeeping by Emily Smith. Let's see if Smith can be up to the task again. Marlins put three players on the goal line. Four, as Shea Geary comes in late. Four players on the goal line. Shenandoah is man-marking those players. Ball into the goal. Unfortunately, it goes over the goal and out of bounds for a goal kick. Marlins were looking to put some pressure on Smith on that play, getting the ball into her box and making her deal with it. 15 minutes into the game, it is 1-0 Shenandoah. Goal kick Shenandoah. Smith with the clearance. Orujo on the ball. Looks to play down the outside back, coming down the flank, is unable to link up. Ball out for a Marlins throw-in. Petticone on the throw. Good win by Shenandoah. Plays their own player going backwards. Under a bit of pressure here. Marlins looking to pin them in. Angel on the ball. Plays Petticone into the middle. Good win by Shenandoah. Gritty battle right here in the midfield. Penn Seal able to come away with the ball, but is blocked by Jackson. Marlins throw. Petticone on the ball. Petticone throws the ball down the sideline to Meinhardt. Meinhardt driving at the Shenandoah defender. Finds Petticone high, looking to get the ball into the box. Crosses it in. Ball bounces inside the six, but no one is able to get a touch to it. Anders on the ball, finds Angel high. Angel driving into the box. Left-footed shot, and it goes wide. Good attack by the Marlins. Continually look to get balls into the box. Substitutions for the Marlins.
Number 14, Marley Hayward.
Forward, Marley Hayward is in the game for number 19, Mia Meinhard. First touches for Hayward. Looks to play Lorenzi through, but is unable to link up. Angel on the ball. Knocks it down for Anders. Plays Lorenzi wide in a 1v1 situation. Looks to dribble. Good defense by the Shenandoah outside back. Penn Seal with the clearance. Peterson on the throw-in for the Marlins. Looking to play Lorenzi's feet. Chooses Hayward. Hayward in a 1v1 battle here. Squares the ball and unable to find anyone, but Petticone is in space. Touch on her right, and she shoots. Oh, off the crossbar. Great hit from Petticone. Unfortunate it does not go in. That hit about as perfectly on the corner of the post and crossbar as you can be. Goal kick for the Hornets. 99, Smith will be taking it. Puts her foot through it. Clears it to midfield. Shenandoah with a big ball. Number seven, Jurgen chasing it down with Geary in pursuit. Geary is able to knock it out for a throw-in. Excuse me, that was Alexa chasing it down. Pensil on the ball. That will be another Shenandoah throw-in. Alexa is on the ball. Plays 18, Pensil. Cleared out to number 21, Morris. Morris looking to get a service into the box. Kakar comes out well and is able to get the ball. Strong goalkeeping by both goalkeepers so far. Not much Kakar could have done on the shot. Kakar with the punt. About half field where Angel is in pursuit. Well done by Shenandoah's Fisher to link up with her center back. Petticone clears the ball forward. Bit of hecticness in the play right now. Knocked down for Alexa. Great ball in. Morris unable to settle it as her touch goes to the goalkeeper. Kakar with the ball and the punt. Petticone versus Morris in the corner, towards the corner. It will be a Shenandoah throw-in. Petticone doesn't like the call. Shenandoah with a bit more pressure these last few minutes. Even though they had the goal, they were definitely pinned in to open the match. But the last few minutes, they've done well and able to put some pressure back on the Marlins. It'll be tough to sustain a one-goal lead if they're defending for the rest of the match. So great for them that they're able to break the pressure and put a little offense together. Hayward, unable to get by the defender, continues to press and is able to force the throw-in. It looks like Pedicure will take that. Safe defense by Shenandoah. Petticone down to Hayward on the throw-in. Looking to turn and play face up. Great ball in. Lorenzi looking to take the defender on. Excellent job by number 21, Morris. Was put in a total 1v1 situation as a defender and able to contain and get just force a throw-in. Excuse me, a corner kick. Anders on the ball. Marlins looking to run a different play on this corner. Their first corner, they put all their players on the goal line. This time they're starting at the top of the box. Shenandoah marked man with a three-player zone, the front post, the back post, and the top of the six. Low ball driven into the 18, cleared away. Arujo on the ball. She looks to get the ball back towards the corner and is unable to link up. Morris on the throw-in for Shenandoah. She hands the ball off to number 11, Sonic. Petticone and Arujo playing team defense on Shenandoah. Arujo on the ball. Is looking to switch the point of attack. Gets it up to Lorenzi. Muscled off the ball, great defense, and a clearance by Shenandoah. Petticone with the knockdown. Angel in pursuit for the Marlins. Geary should be in possession here with pressure from Jurgen. Geary makes the safe decision and clears it wide for a Shenandoah throw-in. When number 10, Emily Jurgen's running at you, you have to be safe. Again, with her career 61 goals, you can't take any chances. Much better to give away the throw-in than let her get that ball. Jurgen on the ball, a little interchange between Shenandoah. Jurgen driving towards the goal, not done yet. No call by the referee, saying number 21, Jackson, got the ball. Cleared back in by Shenandoah to sustain the pressure. Good win. Lorenzi looking to get some possession here. Has Hayward down the sideline. Excellent touch by Morris to not allow that three ball to get down the flank. Peterson with the throw, has Lorenzi, throws to Lorenzi. Lorenzi goes back to goal, looking to link up. Hayward plays a 1-2 with Lorenzi, beats their defender. Should be a Marlins throw. Substitution coming in. Appears to be Lorenzi coming out of the match.
Now in for the Marlins, number 2, Carly Van Rienen.
Van Rienen is entering number 2 for Lorenzi. Lorenzi definitely had a high work rate in this first about 20 minutes. Hayward turns, gets a shot off. Great block by number 30, Infuso, to protect her goalkeeper. Did clear it out for a corner kick, though. Will be the Marlins' third corner of the match. First corner went out for a goal kick directly off the service. Second was not the best service into the box. I'm sure the Marlins are looking to get a little better ball into the box this time. They'll be switching up the player taking their corners. It will be number 10, Petticone. The Marlins are going back to loading up all players on the goal line, and the sun is in the goalkeeper's eyes. Tough for Smith to deal with. Ball directly into the box. Oh, great ball across the six, right across the goal line. Unfortunately, no one was able to get a touch to it. Very dangerous ball. I'm sure if the Marlins get another corner, they'll be looking to run a similar play. Number 20, Marquette, will be taking the goal kick for Smith. This means the offside line is now at the top of the six, since that is the second defender. So Marlins could press a little higher, but great ball by Smith. Or, excuse me, by Marquette. Petticone links up with Jackson. Jackson to Arujo. Good defense by Shenandoah and is able to play out. Anders on the ball, finds Angel. Angel sees Van Riem down the sideline. Looks to play Hayward. Hayward on the sideline, able to force another corner. Let's see if the Marlins run the same play. Petticone's ball in last time was fantastic. All it needed was a slight touch and most likely would have led to a goal. Petticone will be on the ball again, and it does appear the Marlins are loading up the goal line. We'll be interested to see if they have a player really seal the back post. It looks like Kennedy Anders, number 20, is positioning herself back there to allow nothing to get through the box. Ball into the six. The referee has blown the whistle for a foul on the Marlins. Tough to tell who it was on in the mix, but it was prohibited. The foul was prohibiting the keeper. So what's going to happen sometimes when you load up the 6-yard box is you're going to get that call against. You just have to trade it off. You're hoping, looking to get a goal. Arujo with the touch. Shenandoah clears. Alexa in possession for Shenandoah. Able to turn off Crawford and drive at the Marlins. But Crawford gets back in position, is able to poke it away. Arujo turns and faces. She has Angel in the midfield if she'd like to play. But good defense by number 11, Sonic. With Infuso able to help her out. Angel in possession, but is poked away by the Marlins defender. Angel driving, has Hayward in the front, keeps possession well and find Anders. Moves the ball to Jackson. Ball poked away by the Shenandoah defense for a Marlins throw-in. It will be Petticone on the ball. Petticone finds Hayward in the corner. Hayward back to goal, sees Jackson with a cross into the box. Van Riem looking to go up. Good pressure by the Marlins here. Cleared away by Shenandoah. A little bit of desperate defending, but bend, not break, seems to be their motto, and it was well done. Still not allowing a shot through. Hayward finds the ball back to goal inside the box. Angel almost able to control, but not. Jackson on the ball, looks to take a shot. Right-footed shot low, great save by Smith. Very comfortable save. Moved her feet behind the ball well, scooped it clean, no questions asked. She has looked extremely solid in goal so far today. 18.5 remaining here in the first half. We're looking at 1-0 Shenandoah. Knocked down in the midfield, Van Riem in possession. Cuts into the middle. Good D by number 9, Fisher for the Hornets. Ball pops out, possessed by the Marlins. Jackson finds Petticone streaking down the sideline. Petticone's in a 1v1, chooses to cross the ball. Good goalkeeping by Smith again. She is owning her box. If the Marlins want to have success off a cross, they're going to either have to find a head or cross the ball further out, because anything near that six, Smith is all over. Distribution by Smith is a punt to half field. Van Riem settles and finds her teammate Angel. Jackson looks to play Hayward. Hayward in possession with Marquette on her back. Turns and faces up. Looks to play Van Riem down the sideline. Van Rienen, excuse me. Van Rienen on her right plays Angel in the midfield. Good defense by number 14, the goal scorer, Pizzini. Hayward looking to receive the throw-in, is able to turn. The second defender comes in. That looks to be a foul on Hayward. It is a foul. Great second player defense by Morris. The center back loves to see the player from higher up the field coming and helping out. Morris was able to get in, poke the ball away, and win the foul. Give Shenandoah a little room to breathe. Very good team defending. Ball big by Marquette. Up to Penseel, who's able to flick it on to Morris. Morris is driving, finds number 7 in space. Alexa squared up. Well defended. Crawford, it's extremely good 1v1 defense, is able to poke the ball away and then win the foul. The Marlins, although being down a goal, Marlins defense has not been called on a lot, but when it has been, they have been up to the task. Shenandoah sitting extremely deep right now in that three back with 30. Bella Infuso sitting almost inside of her own box. The Shenandoah looks to be keeping the play in front of them at all times. Doesn't want the Marlins to run in behind them. They trust that they can defend them in 1v1 situations. And to this point, they've done a very good job. Looking to keep it up for Shenandoah. Bit of a scrum there and a foul on number 21, Jackson, for the Marlins. Shenandoah will be able to play release pressure, but they play it quick here. Nice little play. Able to find feet. Shenandoah exchange in the midfield. Kicks the ball forward. Shea Geary for the Marlins is able to clear it out. Angel with a nice half turn and finds Anders streaking down the middle. Bit of hecticness in the Shenandoah back line, trying to clear the ball. Able to get it clear where Geary wins the header. Morris driving. Geary once again stepping up a little higher into the midfield this time to poke the ball away. Good battle in that far corner. Looks to have stayed a throw-in and not a corner kick. It is a Shenandoah throw on the next Virginia Wesleyan throw. They will be making another sub. That'll be the Marlins' fourth sub of the match. Interesting that Shenandoah has not made a sub yet, and the Marlins are looking to make their fourth. Last match was against Washington and Lee for Shenandoah, and they only made 2 subs the entire match. It'll be interesting to see how having a bit of a shorter bench affects them late into this match, and if they're able to stay with the fitness of the Marlins. Van Rienen driving at. Great 1v1 defending by Morris. Penseel able to keep it in. Strong tackle by Abby Peterson for the Marlins. Van Rienen able to keep the ball in play and play it up to Hayward. Hayward driving. Gets a half a yard of space on number 20. Marquette crosses the ball into the mix to Arujo, unable to link up. Anders on the ball, sprays the ball nicely to the right side where Jackson is looking to get into the box, but well defended by Sarasonic of Shenandoah. Pokes the ball out for a Marlins throw-in where they will be making their sub. It will be Reyna Arujo coming out. Had a great first half.
Now in for the Marlins.
High work rate.
Number 5. Gabrielle Lindo.
Lindo is in up front for the Marlins, looking to combine with Hayward. Throw into Hayward, poked away by Shenandoah. Morris streaking up the sideline. Petticone with the tackle. Looks to remain Shenandoah ball. So Nock taking the throw for Shenandoah. Clears the first line of players. Marlins get the ball to Geary, who plays it out wide to Peterson. Peterson looking to play into the midfield, finds Anders driving at space. Lindo looking to get her first touch of the game, but ball goes through her legs and rolls to Smith. Again, quick off her line to keep things tidy in the back. It appears number 10, Jurgen, for Shenandoah has dropped all the way in as a center back, almost sweeper-like position, with a fantastic tackle right there on Hayward. Yes, it appears she's in a sweeper-like position. That was a fantastic tackle on Hayward. Very interesting. In the first half, it seems that Shenandoah got their goal and is willing to play a lot of defense for the rest of this match if they're moving their 60-plus career goal score into the back line. Ball appears to be off the Marlins for a Shenandoah throw, and number 14 will be taking it. Spazzini, the goal scorer. Shea Geary with a great step through to win the ball, not allowing it to get to Alexa. Morris on the ball. Morris plays Pensil. Pensil has the space to turn, doesn't know it though. Plays forward, Shea Geary with the win. Angel in possession, has her outside back, unable to find Van Rienen. Morris into the mix where it's taken by Angel. Angel's driving, has her other midfielder to link up with, plays Lindo. Around the outside is Jackson, finds Jackson. Petticone trying to get around her on the edge as well. Looking to get Lindo back involved. Good defense. Very good defense by Infuso, number 30 for Shenandoah. Able to muscle Lindo off the ball while not giving away a foul or a touch. So it goes, that will be a goal kick, Shenandoah. Goal kick taken. Number 9 is able to get the first touch. That is Fisher for Shenandoah, who then clears the ball down the sideline. Crawford under a bit of pressure here. Definitely under a bit of pressure. A great pressure by Shenandoah. Crawford is able to spin out to her left. Finds the ball at the sideline. Let's see if Linda can get a touch before it goes out of bounds. She is unable to. That'll be a throw-in for Sonic for Shenandoah. Finds her defender stepping into the midfield, who then finds Fisher on the ball, driving at Crawford, looking to win some sort of throw-in corner kick, and is unable to. That's good D by Crawford. That'll be a Marlins goal kick. Two more subs here by the Marlins. Let's see who they are. 10 minutes left in the first half, and it is 1-0 Shenandoah. Again, Shenandoah have not had most of the chances. I'd say the chances probably 4-1 or so for the Marlins. But again, making the most of their one chance and burying a shot about 12 yards out off a knockdown.
Now in for the Marlins, number 4, Ryan McCurry, and number 11, Sarah Heinball.
As you heard, McCurry into the midfield and Heinball up front, number 11. With Heinball going up front, Heinball appears to have pushed Lindo, number 5, on the ball right now, back into the midfield. Looking to make an immediate impact. McCurry with a touch, unable to link up with Heinbauer. Petticone driving. Well defended. McCurry in possession, but is well defended by Shenandoah. Morris was able to win the ball without getting a touch to get and got the throw in. Morris on the ball again for Shenandoah. Chips the ball into the midfield where Jackson looks to play. Unable to find a teammate. Shea Geary is going to have to clear. Does well to Marley Hayward up front. A good turn by Marley Hayward. Heinbauer driving off the ball by Hayward. And Smith quick off her line again to get possession for the Hornets. Punt is a little short where Lindo is able to win the header off a bounce. Looks to settle it. Unable to. Shenandoah is coming at, clears the ball down into the corner. Alexa is putting pressure on Crawford. Crawford has the ball. She's able to find Geary in the middle. Geary with the big ball. Lindo looks to settle, has space to turn, is able to turn. But forward pass is blocked by number 14 for Shenandoah. Spazzini, she has been everywhere today. Great match for her so far. It will be Petticone's throw. One by Shenandoah, out for another throw. Petticone on the ball again for a throw-in. Looks to play Heinball. In possession. Advances about 15 yards and will be another Marlins throw, taken again by Petticone. Hayward able to create a little bit of hecticness. Ball moves forward. Heinball with the pressure. Shenandoah able to clear it. Could be a foul on Crawford, but not called. Crawford is driving into the midfield as that right back, or as the center back, excuse me. Petticone is the right back. All the way on the left flank now, definitely looking to find a teammate. Is able to find Crawford, or is able to find Peterson, excuse me. Now Anders. Angel gets stuck in on the tackle. Anders out to McCurry. McCurry. Lindo in possession. Looks to take the shot. Saved by Smith. Not the surest of hands that time. I would not call that a blunder, but that is her first non-fantastic play of the day. A ball slipping through her hands a little, but she was fine. Had the ball in plenty of space, able to connect, and now a good punt out to half field. Angel winning the knockdown. Space in front, able to drive a little bit. Looks to play Hayward down the left flank. Hayward able to block the clearance by Morris. Hayward looks to get the cross in, is unable. Jurgen, the sweeper, is able to clear the ball out for Shenandoah. Pensil on the ball, nice turn to get away from her defender. Clears the ball and is going to make Geary have to play. No, ball just gets out of bounds before Alexa could get there for the Hornets. Geary on the throw, looks to find Angel. Flag is up. It should be a Shenandoah throw. There it is. A little confusion by our officiating staff, the guys in orange. Alexa to Pensil, to Alexa, back to Pensil, who looks to find a player in the midfield, unable to link up. Angel in the ball, sees Lindo, a little bit of space for Heinbold to run into. Heinbold running towards the goal, but Jurgen is back and she is fast. You can see Shenandoah again, they do not want the Marlins to get behind them. With Jurgen back there, she has the speed to protect that back line and let nothing in that space. Heinbold on the ball, looking to turn, creates a little bit of space to McCurry. Petticone on the right flank, touches by. Good defense. Should be a foul on someone. And it goes against the Marlins. Fair call. Number 20 looks to be trotting over to take the kick. That's Abby Marquette. Little over 5 minutes remaining in this first half. 1-0 Shenandoah. Both teams looking to close the half out. Shenandoah most likely looking to close it. I think they'd be happy going into half 1-0. Marlins are definitely looking to try to equalize before the end of the half. Petticone on the throw. Looking for Heinbold down the line. Heinbold gets it. Left-footed ball. No one there. Shenandoah able to win the first and second ball. Petticone tries to keep it in. Lindo with the outside of the foot touch. Nice bit of skill. Goes to turn and is unable. Good swarm defense by Shenandoah. Alexa with a nice touchdown for her midfielder. Petticone having to play towards her own goal. Knocks it out for a Shenandoah throw-in. Morris coming up for Shen to take the throw. Finds Alexa. Alexa driving in on her right. Has a bit of space. Kakar able to get the ball. Pushing everyone up the field for the punt. Good contact with the ball. Well won by number 9, Fisher, for Shenandoah. Petticone with a bit of space. Takes a heavy touch where she's met by Fisher. Fisher is able to win and possess. Looks to play Alexa. Alexa in the corner, heading towards the corner. Flag is up. It will be a Marlins throw-in. Another Marlins throw-in taken again by Petticone. Heinbaugh in the ball. Unable to get first touch. Gets a bit away from her. Shenandoah takes it back. Good bit of play here by Shenandoah. Good bit of pressure, not allowing the Marlins to get out. Peterson stepped through where she is fouled. Foul worked out very well for Shenandoah, stopping the Marlins counterattack. Crawford on the ball. Hits a long ball to Hayward in some space. Looks to take it down. Touch gets a bit away from her. It's okay. McCurry is able to clean up the scraps. Cut back well into the midfield. Looking to find some feet. Well defended by Shenandoah. Bit of space here. She turns to her right, but Alexa turned to her left, looking to find a teammate now in possession. She is able to find Fisher. Fisher driving. Well defended by Lindo. McCreary to Angel. Beats her man. Oh, cuts back again. And number 20, Marquette was able to get, was able to, after getting beat, get back and get a touch on the ball. Way not to give up on the play. Not the best kick by Kakar. Off her line quickly, though, was able to receive the ball. Petticone, short to Petticone. Petticone in possession. Looks to go big, but it's blocked. She has Lindo. Played Lindo. Lindo turns and is in acres of space. Hindball down the side. Plays Hindball. Looks to take her man on. Puts it through her legs. Fantastic bit of dribbling. Gets it caught on her feet on the next player, though. Has Petticone back. Links up with Petticone. Looks to play the one-touch ball and doesn't hit it clean. Unfortunate. Decent bit of play by the Marlins, just needs to be a little tighter. Minute 30 remaining in the half, Petticone on the ball. Hindball shows in, doesn't get it. Now looks to get it again, she's on it. Plays Lindo. Will be a Marlins throw-in, minute 20. Looking to play Hayward. Unable to find her feet, but she is able again to force a throw-in. Petticone to Hayward. Ball is inside the box. Turns to her left.
1 minute remaining in the first half. 1 minute.
Cleared by Shenandoah towards half field. Crawford able to keep it in bounds. Has Petticone in front of her. Has McCreary to McCreary. Tries to play one touch to Petticone. Is unable to find her feet. Petticone looks to throw the ball down the sideline. Marlins looking to get a bit of pressure here before the end of the half. Lindo in the ball. Not the best contact, but the shot did go towards the goal where it was cleared out by number 10, Emily Juergen. McCreary on the ball. Able to find Jackson. Shot towards the frame where it is collected by Smith. That shot was by Kennedy Anders. Smith has the ball. I'm sure she will be looking to take a little bit of time off the clock here. Go big and just try to get the Hornets to the end of the half.
10
seconds remaining.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4,
Marlins in possession, looking to clear, and that will be the first half.
1-0. Score at the end of the first half is the Marlins 0, the Hornets 1.
At the end of the first, it is Shenandoah 1, Marlins 0. Been a great game so far. We look forward to a great second half in 15 minutes. And we're back to action for the second half. In this half, the Marlins will be going left to right and the Hornets going right to left. Arujo on the ball. He's muscled off by number 30, Bella Infuso. Great start to the half. A lot of energy out of these two teams. You can expect them both to come out ripping. 19 looking to drive. That is Taylor Morris looking to drive at Shea Gary, but Shea does a great job and is able to poke it away, but Shenandoah keeps the pressure on. A lot of life out of these two teams off the early go here. Peterson is able to poke it wide for a Shenandoah throw-in. Shenandoah still appears to be leaving number 10, Emily Juergen, their leading goal scorer at center back right now, looking to probably play a little bit of prevent defense and not allow the Marlins to get in behind. Marlins lining up in a 4-2-2-2. Looks like they have a box in the midfield. Angel, one of the midfielders, able to get possession, looks to play Arujo in, but is unable to link up. Crawford on the ball, has Arujo down the line, goes to clip it, but is unable to keep it in bounds. Arujo and Meinhardt looking to put a little bit of pressure. Right back, Petticone doesn't, but is able to force Shenandoah into a flick. Ball goes long towards Hayward, where Juergen is able to win it. Back to the center back of Virginia, Wesley and Gary. She finds the left back, Peterson, is in a bit of space. She's looking to drive, has Hayward in front of her. Looks to cut it back, but good defense by Shenandoah. Unfortunate bounce. Big ball across to Meinhardt, who puts pressure on the Shenandoah back line and forces them into a throw-in. Petticone will be coming up to take the ball on the right, towards the right corner for a throw-in. Has Jackson in a lot of space in the midfield, but doesn't seem to be looking at her. Goes to Meinhardt, looks to spin her defender, gets the ball on her right foot. If she holds this off, it will be a corner, and she's able to hold her off for a Virginia Wesleyan corner kick. Let's see who goes to the ball. Looks like Petticone will be taking it. Petticone's a righty, so the ball it should be an outswinger. An outswinger is where, since she's taking the ball on the right side with her right foot, the ball will swing away from the goal instead of curling in. The Marlins are putting everyone on the line again, looking to attack, where Shenandoah is playing defense man-to-man with post and one zone in the front of the six. Ball's a little far out, probably for their liking. Looks to get a touch, unable to. Good defense by Shenandoah, blocking any chance of a shot. Ball popped back out to Petticone, looking to serve it back in the mix. Not the best ball in, squibs it across the ground, but Shenandoah with the clearance forces out for another corner kick. Let's see the play that the Marlins run. Marlins look to put everyone back on the goal line, look to make a redo of last time. If you're able to see, Meinhardt is looking to definitely impede Smith in goal. She'll have to do so without getting a foul called on her. Smith is looking to find an angle to get out. Petticone gets the ball in. Ball gets squibs through to the back post, where Anders gets it back in. Shot goes wide. It will be a goal kick for the Hornets. Good bit of pressure to open the half from the Marlins, but it's going to take more than a bit of pressure to get a goal against this solid defense of the Hornets. Looks like Marquette will be taking the goal kick. Ball cleared to almost half field, where Anders is able to get a touch and knock it out of bounds. Will be a throw-in taken by Morris. Morris back in possession. Knocks it forward. Morris on the ball. Plays Morris. Pass out to Hayward. Looks to go big. Slipping behind. Meinhardt is running towards the goal. She is in on the frame. Takes the early shot. Goalkeeper gets a touch, but it squibbles through. Goal for the Marlins. Fantastic finish by number 19, Mia Meinhardt. Takes the ball early before the goalkeeper is ready. Slots it row. Emily Smith does everything she can. Does a great job getting a touch, but is unable to keep it out of the net. We're looking at a 1-1 game with 40 minutes to go. Let's see how Shenandoah responds now, and if they leave their goal scorer in the back line. That's got to be a momentum boost for the Marlins, getting that goal back nice and early, 5 minutes into the half.
Goal scored by number 19, Mia Meinhardt. Assisted by number 14, Marley Hayward.
Was a great ball by Hayward to find Meinhardt deep behind the line. Definitely what the Hornets were trying to prevent for this match so far was that ball in behind and trying to keep the play in front of them. But Marlins did a great job. Angel has the ball going down the left sideline, looking to get it back on her preferred right foot. Takes it left. Good job, Angel. Angel spins, goes end line, gets a cross off. Good goalkeeping by Smith. Collects it cleanly. Marlins with a lot of energy right now. Definitely looking to get a second while that's in their favor. Cleared out by Smith on the punt. Anders contesting with Fisher. Fisher on the ball. Links back to her midfielder, where Shea Gary is able to step through for the Marlins and win the ball. That's Spinazzi on the clearance, excuse me. Spazzini. Peterson in the corner for the Marlins, looking to spin out of it. Does a good job, is able to turn, but no one is there to help her. Will be a throw-in for the Hornets. Looks to be a little high up, but they allow it. Kristen Fisher plays back. In possession, the shot towards the frame. Collected by Amruta Kakar. Good safe save. Kept the ball in front of her, moved her feet well. Looking to release. Punt towards half field, well over half field. Great kick by Amruta. Hayward with the flick onto herself, but Jurgen is there to clean. Crawford on the ball, finds Geary. Geary's taking no chances and also releases the ball big. Peterson finds Anders. Ball blocked. Penseel driving at Shea Geary. Shea Geary with a great tackle. Marlins looking to get the ball up as quickly as possible to their forward players and let them go to work. Shea Geary, she has been everywhere today with another fantastic step through. Jackson not able to get it. Ball pops out to Petticone, who finds Meinhardt through. Jackson is open in the middle. Meinhardt driving towards the center of the park. Runs into three defenders. Maybe should have passed, but it works hard and is able to help get it back. Petticone pokes it away to Crawford. Crawford on the right side. Crawford finds a bit of space. Well done to step through the play. She's able to find Anders in the middle. Anders going to get it. A little confusing with Angel, but they're able to work it out. Finds teammate Hayward running towards the left corner. Cuts it back inside. We're once a big ball in now. Well stepped through by the Shenandoah defender. Angel not letting it be easy, though, and put some pressure on. Shenandoah able to combine well just to get a little bit of room to clear, but once again, Shea Geary is there to keep the pressure on. Ball ends up going all the way through to the goalkeeper where Smith collects. Smith now, again, looks to go big, gets her players up. And here's the punt. Big ball to about half field, where Bella Infuso wins the knockdown. Alexa streaking down the sideline, poked away by number 30, Abby Peterson. Appears to be a corner. It will be the first one of the match for the Hornets. Let's see what they can do. Play short. Petticone pops out. Great awareness by Petticone to not allow the short corner to build. Petticone stays on it. It's a 2v2 here in the corner. Ball pops high for Shenandoah. Good pass. Ball towards the frame. Goes wide. Early sub for the Marlins.
Now in the game for the Marlins, number 15, Allie Fitz.
Fitz coming in for Angel. Angel's done a great job. College rules, Angel is able to re-enter in the second half, so I wouldn't be surprised if we see her again. Crawford on the ball. Good kick past midfield. Great job releasing. Hayward flicks it on to herself. She's able to flick it on again and is fouled by number 10, Emily Jurgen. A ref appears to have stopped the clock. Normally that means a booking, and yes, it is. Yellow card for Emily Jurgen. 36 minutes to go, and the player that Shenandoah is using as their last defender, whether you want to call it a sweeper or a deep-lying center back, is in the book. Could turn out to be pretty important if there's another tackle that she has to make where she's a little behind the ball and puts herself in a situation where she might get yellow carded. But the three-time All-ODAC Freshman of the Year, Emily Juergen, I'm sure she is no... This is her 71st start, as mentioned earlier, so she is no stranger to playing in big games. I'm sure she'll be able to behave herself and conduct herself so she won't pick up that second yellow. That's a veteran player. That was a good foul as well. Very tactical. Now on the ball for the Marlins is Crawford. Three-man wall for the Hornets. Appears to be lining up for a shot, Crawford. Could be across towards the back post. Petticone with a lot of space back there, and it is a shot. Floating towards the back post. Goes over the net. Goal kick. Pretty harmless. Bella Infuso to take the kick. Goal kicks off. Well struck. About half field. A little confusion by the Marlins on who's going to win that, and is able to get picked up by number 9, Kristen Fisher, for the Hornets. Playing Alexa down the sideline. Shea Geary with the step is able to win it nicely, and she finds Hayward. Let's see if Hayward can link up with Fitz. Good turn by Hayward. She has Fitz in a bit of space. Is able to get the ball towards Fitz. Can she find a player in the middle? Well done to keep possession. Didn't advance the ball, but is able to keep possession for the Marlins. Anders goes big. Hayward on the ball. Well defended by Shenandoah. Good battle. Little bit of room here for Shenandoah. Let's see what they can put together. Pensila's on the ball. Gets on her left foot. But once again, Geary is there. She has been everywhere. The Connecticut native playing a great game at center back for the Marlins. Emily Juergen chased down the long ball, but goalkeeper Smith called her off. Good communication between the two players for Smith to securely receive the ball. Punt out towards Petticone and Morris. Morris finds Sonic. Clips the ball down the sideline. Looks like it should be rolling out for a goal kick. Let's see if Geary chooses to keep it in or allow it to go out. She lets it go out. Goal kick, Marlins. Crawford looks to take the goal kick for the Marlins. See if they push the players up the field or go short. They appear to be going big. 34 minutes remaining here. Not the best kick by Crawford. Morris is able to receive it where Petticone and her in a 1v1. Petticone wins the ball back, goes to clear it with her right foot. Deflected out by Morris. It will be a Marlins throw-in. That has to be a Marlins throw-in, correct? Yes, it is. They're allowing the Marlins to sub. Only sub on your own throws in college.
Number 4, Ryan McCurry.
Entering the game will be Ryan McCurry. She is replacing number 20, Kennedy Anders, in the middle. As I previously said, Anders will be able to re-enter in the second half of play. Long ball forward by number 20, Abby Marquette. Spazzini on the ball. There is a whistle, and it will be a Marlins free kick. Crawford is on the ball for the Marlins. Big gap in the midfield right now if there is a knockdown for the Marlins. Long ball towards Meinhard. Flicks it on towards Hayward. But Smith, quickly off her line, is able to collect. Hayward maybe with a bit extra there. Morris did not like that from Shenandoah, but there wasn't much in it. This game has been extremely clean so far. Both teams just fighting very hard, trying to get that advance to the ODAC semifinals. Throw in. Some disagreement. Petticone is caught out of position as Shenandoah takes it quick. Marlins go back to their goalkeeper for the first time of the day, where Reyna puts it behind her back, and not the best clearance, but is able to get it past the first defender. Bit of hecticness there between not knowing who the throw-in was and then the goalkeeper not hitting the firmest ball, but the Marlins able to weather the storm and get it out for a throw-in. Shenandoah back on the ball, where Infuso steps into the midfield, is looking for a teammate. Fitz is putting some intense pressure, tackles and doesn't get it, but forces the player to take a poor touch. Spinizzi, the goal scorer, on the ball. Ball pops out to the Marlins, where Hayward is in possession, driving Reyna Arujo in a lot of space here on the right side. Unable to get it to her, they elect to go down the left towards Fitz, where Emily Juergen is able to get over and clear. Morris on the ball, finds Alexa to Fisher, who goes big. Ball pops up to Pensiel. It's a bit of 1v1 defending here for Crawford, who wins the battle. Job well done for Crawford. Crawford, the freshman from Bensalem, Pennsylvania, just did an excellent job there. Has been a staple in the Marlins' back line all season. Right there, showing why she's getting the nod as a freshman. Excellent defending against a fantastic sophomore in Pensiel. Marlins looking to put a bit of pressure. Ball forces a long ball that goes out for a throw-in. Pedicure on the ball. Goes forward towards Meinhardt. Has Arujo running behind. Pensiel on the ball. Crawford steps to put a bit of pressure. Fitz attempts to play it for the Marlins. Once again, ball ends up at Shea Gary's feet. Pass over to Jackson. Jackson looking to link up with Fitz, but unable to. Bit of space here for the Hornets to run into. Crawford steps out. Spazzini keeps going. Spazzini was in a bit of space there, but eventually got tackled. She is the goal scorer from the first half for the Hornets. Dual substitutions. The Marlins are allowed to sub here since also the Hornets are subbing.
For the Hornets, number one, Casey Boren.
Casey.
And for the Marlins, number two, Carly Van Rienen.
Number one, Casey Morin, is replacing number 18, Maya Pensiel, for the Hornets. That's their first sub of the evening. Juergen on the ball. Has her left back in a fair amount of space. Finds her. That's Morin. First touches of the day for her. Gets a good ball in, is well controlled by number 19, Morris. Hectusness here. Shenandoah with the hit. Floats harmlessly over the ball. That ball was struck by Kristen Fisher. Good spell of play for the Hornets. 29 remaining here in the second half. 1-1. Crawford on the ball for the goal kick. Electing to go big. Ball driven into the midfield towards Van Rienen. Flicked on by the Hornets. Alexa is on the ball, looking to find some space on the left, where she's tackled by Pettacone and able to keep possession. Big touch, not pressured. My heart's running if she can get the ball down the sideline. Looks to clip it, but unable to keep it in bounds there. Marlins can put a bit of pressure here if they get over to the side in time, which they do. Number 9 is open. Ball advances about 5 yards, where it'll be again a Shenandoah throw-in. Able to find number 9, Fisher. No whistle. Players of both teams seem to think there was a foul, but nothing called. Anders on the ball. Finds Arujo. McCurry stepping through. Van Rienen driving at the goalkeeper. Ball pops out. Smith able to make the first save on almost a bang-bang play with Van Rienen. Gave up a bit of a rebound, but was on it very quickly. In reality, still a fairly safe play for Shenandoah. Well defended. Big by Smith. McCurry wins the knockdown towards Van Rienen. Tries to find Meinhardt, but is unable to get it there, but is able to put pressure and get a touch on the ball as it pops out. Meinhardt putting a bit of pressure, cleared away by number 10, Juergen. Foul by Reyna Arujo. Good call. She wasn't letting the player advance. Quickly played by the Hornets. Fisher driving at him in the midfield. Alexa hit the ball long, where Geary wins the knock. Arujo looking to link up with a teammate. Unable to find, and Morris will collect. Morris beats Petticone down the sideline on her left foot, looking to get into the box. Petticone with the tackle. That will be a corner kick for the Hornets. They're sending two players again. Let's see if the Marlins are on top of it and don't allow the short. It's a two-on-one, still an advantageous play. Goes high, pops out to passes out to Marquette, looking to get a ball in the mix. Crosses it through. Amruta gets a touch. Team save. Great shot by the Hornets in the confusion, but a team save by number 21, Jackson, to preserve the 1-1 draw. Goalkeeper's best friend is when your defender clears one off the line for you like that. I'm sure she'll be thanking her later this evening. Marlins able to clear the ball past half, where it falls to Morris, goes to clear it, gets deflected. Should be a foul. Called, it'll be Marlins free kick. About 7 yards into their own half, the Marlins will have the ball on a free kick. Crawford will be taking it. Marlins load up towards the top of the box, looking to clip the ball long as she does. It's a Rujo, ball pops past. Van Rien is able to get on the ball. Cuts it back, looks to play. Reyna Arujo unable to link up. Juergen, safety first, clears it long. Out for a throw in Marlins. Petticone is on the ball. Looks to find Arujo, who wins it off the deflection. Keeps the ball in, well done. Petticone big again. Van Rien to put a bit of pressure on the substitute, Morin. Morin does a great job. Morris looking for options. Ball goes out of bounds. Will be a Petticone throw-in for the Marlins. Marlins making a triple substitution here. Let's see who's coming off. It looks like McCurry is coming off. The goal scorer, Mia Meinhardt, will be coming off. That's two. And the third player exiting the game for the Marlins will be number 22, Reyna Arujo. We have some fresh legs on, and Taya Lorenzi. Allie Angel came back onto the field, and so does Marley Harrod. Allie Angel with the early hit on her left foot, right down the middle of the goal. Safe save from Emily Smith. Let's see if the Marlins look to put a bit more pressure here with the triple substitution of fresh legs against the Hornets, who have only made one sub on the day. 24 minutes remaining in the game. Hornets do not normally go very deep on the bench, so you have to expect their players to be battle-hardened and fit, ready to play the rest of this out. Ball gets slipped through to Lorenzi. Lorenzi on the right corner looks to find Hayward back in the middle, and it is a foul on Hayward. The fans don't appear to like that call, but it seems like the right call, as number 10, Emily Juergen, got the first touch, and then Marley Hayward came into her late. Nothing in it, just two great players going hard, trying to get the points for their team. Good defending, good offense, and you love to see it. Cleared out by the Hornets, where Spinizzi, the goal scorer, is able to collect. Dispossessed by Jackson, who looks to slip the ball down the sideline. Hayward's not making it easy. Forces the ball out of bounds, where it'll be a Marlins throw-in. Has Lorenzi quick. Petticone electing not to play it. Angel coming to get. Finds Hayward, spins off, looking for Angel. Well defended. Jackson receives at the top of the box. Unfortunate touch gives it away. Arujo is out. Oh, that's Reyna Arujo. My mistake. She did not come off in the substitution moments ago, but she did flick it on to Marley Hayward, who gets it off. Oh, goalkeeper appeared to have lost her footing. Yes, you can see her clipping out her boots right now. Lost her footing as that ball almost shriggled into the back post, but Smith did appear to have it covered. Good attack by the Marlins. As I previously mentioned, my mistake, Reyna Arujo simply moved from the right wing to the left wing, so she did not come off the field moments ago. Ball clipped into the midfield. Good win by Jackson, where Lorenzi is fighting for it. Foul on the Marlins. Morin wins the ball. That's the substitute for Shenandoah. Well done. Looks to be taken by number 20, Abby Marquette. Clips the ball long. Anders wins the ball initially, but it pops out to Shenandoah. Good turn by Fisher, driving at the defense. Shea Geary reads the play well and steps through. Lorenzi for the Marlins looking to get on the end of this. Morin applying a bit of pressure along with Fisher. Well won by Jackson. She has players up the field. Unable to find Hayward's feet. Petticone on the ball. Elects to go to Lorenzi, who stepped in front of by Morin. Lorenzi still on it. Angel looks to go out the other side. Has Shea Geary stepping through the midfield. Looks to play Reyna Arujo in behind Arujo. Ball collected by Smith and Gall, looking to go big. Here's the punt. Clips it out to half field. Ball gets by the first players. Abby Peterson is looking to contest. Out of bounds for Marlins throw-in. Left back Abby Peterson should take this. Referee is just holding her up here while there's a second ball on the field being knocked off by Shea Geary. Good chance for Coach Jeff Bowers to give some instructions to his Marlins team. Ball thrown into Hayward, who collects, goes to turn, unable to control it, and it goes out for a Shenandoah throw-in right in front of their bench. Morris with the fake throw, got me. Ball goes, Peterson with the knockdown. Arujo with the win, she collects, looking to switch the point of attack to Lorenzi. Morin does a good job of reading it. Angel steps through the midfield. It's a good hard battle in there where she's able to retain possession and play Crawford. Bit of a softball back, gets blocked in, and Alexa's running at him. Crawford is able to regain, finds a bit of space here. She has tons of space here in the midfield for Arujo. Game is getting stretched. You had to expect it a little late in the match, where she's able to find Angel again in a lot of space. Clips the ball out to Petticure at the right back. Petticone looking to get a cross in. Crosses in, which is blocked for a corner kick. Excuse me, that was not Petticone on the cross. That was Jackson, the midfielder, stepping into the play. Petticone will go take this corner kick for the Marlins. It's been about 20 minutes since the Marlins had a corner. They look to be running the same play where they stack the goal line. And again, defended by the man marking with two posts and number 21 working the zone. Ball clipped in, doesn't find anyone. Cleared out by Shenandoah. Bit of a 1v1 here. Marlins will have to track back. Alexa's running right at him with the big touch. And she's able to get around. Great defending by Croft. Oh, excuse me. Hard foul by Alexa. Referee stopped the clock. It has to be a booking. Referee shows the yellow card for number 7, Abby Alexa. Bit of frustration probably in that tackle as she thought she was in and well defended by Crawford. Her teammate Emily Jurgen, number 10, has done an excellent job playing the last 15, 20 minutes on a yellow. Let's see if she can do the same. Big by the Marlins towards Angel. A little bit of a push in the back, but not called. Hayward collects, no big deal. Jurgen, well job to step in, and a foul by Hayward. They're looking to play quick. Where they play Morris. Marlins shut off for a bit, but not the best touch. Petticone able to put a little bit of pressure and get it back. Lorenzi here, looking to drive down the sideline against Morin. Foul on Lorenzi. Three fouls in about the last minute. Referee definitely looking to get control of the game here. Referee has stopped the clock. Looking to talk to a player, I'm not sure who. Might have been Angel in the Marlins, just having a little quick chat. Tell her enough with the talking, let's play. 21, that's Jackson with the win. Angel steps through, finds Hayward, little 1-2, good build. Tries to find her back, unable to get it through Marquette. But they're able to get a poke and get a touch on and win the ball where she finds Petticone in space. Petticone in space here. Morin able to hold Lorenzi back. That is a The foul's going against Lorenzi in a booking. Although that's a light call, it's accumulation of fouls will be what that's recorded for in the referee's match report. Lorenzi had about 2 or 3 fouls in the last 90 seconds, which most likely led to that booking. Again, referee just looking to control the match. 18 minutes to go, both teams really contesting it. You'd rather see it not get chippy. Petticone with a push in the back, not called though, as she wins the ball forward. Morris comes through. Lorenzi links up with Jackson. Lorenzi on the ball again. Morin does a good job pushing her off. Good tackle by Angel, allowing nothing to get through. Jackson getting stuck in here with Fisher, with Spinizi, excuse me. Should be a Marlins throw. The Hornets will be looking to make their second substitution the next time they have opportunity, either a goal kick or they're throwing. Only their second substitution of the match. Pedicure throws the ball forward where Morin wins it. Crawford dribbles to her weak foot left. Angel to Anders. Able to find Peterson on the wide. No call. Good defense by Sarah Sonic, who then releases to Alexa. Great idea on the counterattack. Bit of a big touch where Amruta Kakar was able to receive the ball. Amruta slowing the game down here. Makes sense. Goes big. Let's see if the Marlins can get a win. Ball goes through where Angel goes to collect. Push in the back. Good call. Definitely getting feisty out there. Foul appeared to be on number 30, Bella Infuso, on the push against Angel in the back. Crawford on the ball. Marlins putting players towards the top of the box, looking to get that ball into the mix. Here's the ball. Flat low. Good win by number 10, Jurgen. Flicked out by number 20, Marquette, where Alexa gets the ball in some space. Let's look to see if she touches and goes big like last time. Crawford is putting some good pressure on her. Gets her to turn backwards and no... That's just great defense by Crawford. Was able to turn Alexa and make her face her own goal after a 1v1 situation. The Hornets will be making a sub here. Number one will be coming out of the game, Casey Morin, and entering...
For the Hornets, number 24, Jocelyn Granados.
And entering will be Granados as a left back. That's the second substitution at left back. Morin did a great job in the minutes played. Throws to Morris, where she's getting some pressure by Petticone, who pokes it away. Jurgen on the ball, goes big towards their right forward, who's pressured by Peterson. Peterson versus Sonic, good little battle there. With 15 and a half minutes remaining, we're at 1-1. Let's not forget, last time these two teams played, it went all the way to double overtime. So these teams are not unaccustomed to going long matches, late matches against one another. Big ball in by Crawford. Shenandoah wins the first, where it pops out to Anders, who tries to clip it down the corner for Arujo. Arujo faces up. Find Anders. Anders back towards the middle where she sees Angel. Well defended by Shenandoah, clears their lines, gets it to Crawford, who pokes it again ahead. A lot of contact in the middle. Peterson with the win. The midfielders of the Marlins are able to link up and find a bit of space. Ball pops out, ball gets to Hayward, who's then cleared out by number 30 in Fuso. Peterson versus Sonic in the ball there. Peterson's able to merge this time. She's able to link up with Marley Hayward, who turns towards the middle of the pitch. Looks to clip a big ball towards Lorenzi, but it didn't go through. After a few bounces around, pops out to the Marlins right back, Petticone, who elects to let it roll out. She sees Lorenzi in front of her. She chooses to throw it to Lorenzi. Lorenzi's got the substitute defender Granados on her back. Turns inside. Good pressure cover defending. Slip down the line. Unable to link up with Hayward. Jackson clips the ball forward. Lorenzi will be looking to put some pressure here. Coming around the outside edge. She's able to get the edge. Can she get a corner kick? Crosses the ball into the mix to Smith. Smith collects comfortably. Lorenzi's having a word with the assistant referee. Wanted a call there, but didn't get one. And didn't seem like there was a lot in it for her to get. Smith clears her line with a punt, where Angel wins the initial ball. Finds a bit of space in the midfield. Lorenzi has some room. She gets it out to Lorenzi. Let's see if she can square up. She does. She's in a 1v1 situation versus the substitute Granados. Has the ball on her right. Good 1v1 defending by the Shenandoah right back. Call on Lorenzi. interesting decision. It did seem like the Shenandoah player just fell over and there was a foul on neither team, but referee chooses and we play on. Pettacone gets the ball, cuts into the middle, where she's able to link up with Jackson. Jackson cuts back on her right foot. She finds Angel. Angel's in a bit of room here. She plays the ball wide to Lorenzi. They keep going down this right side. Lorenzi with the cross. Out of bound for a goal kick. Substitute Marlins. It's Mia Meinhard. Let's see who she comes in for. All three of the forwards are moving around, so tough to see who she's taking right now. She appears to be taking number 28, Taya Lorenzi. Lorenzi with a great shift of play right there, but the ball was constantly down her sideline. I could see why she needs a rest. Peterson versus Sonic again. Marlins throw where she's able to find Meinhard. Looks to play the right winger, Arujo, but unfortunately Arujo was a bit tucked in by the time the ball came. Clearance by Shen. Pops out for a Marlins throw now. Pedicure on the ball. That's the right back. Looking to advance the ball, play forward. She throws it to Meinhard. Defender gets in the way. Good win by Shenandoah. Jackson drives, unable to get it. Step through by Crawford. Picks it off before it could get to Alexa. Plays Meinhard. Arujo's in a bit of space. Alexa to go back inside. Mia gets caught with the ball at her foot instead of playing it. Maybe should have got that touch off earlier. It looks to be a Marlins throw-in. Pedico on the right back will be taking the throw-in. Angels checking. Alexa to go to Meinhard. Doesn't quite get there. Reyna Arujo putting some pressure here. Forces the Shenandoah clearance into another throw. Pettacone on the ball. Towards Meinhard. Let's get some movement off her. Reyna Arujo on the ball. Wants to go to her right. Cross is blocked for a corner kick. Pettacone looks to go to take it. Just over 10 minutes remaining. Marlins corner. For about the fifth or sixth time of the day, the Marlins will be running the play where they put everyone on the goal line. Meinhard has to be careful not to foul goalkeeper Smith or else it will result in a dead ball. Pettacone gets the ball in. Smith comes and doesn't quite get there. A little confusion by the goalkeeper. And that's a foul by Reyna Arujo. Might be lucky not to get a card on that one, as it appeared she would be running in a bit of space. Clearance blocked by the Marlins, or excuse me, I should say deflected, as it remains a Shenandoah throw-in. Sonic throws the ball back to Morris, who gets it up to Alexa. Excuse me, that was not Sonic. Regardless, Crawford has cleared the ball where it is under, where Granados, the substitute left back, received it. She has room to turn if the players let her know. She finds her deep-lying center back, Emily Juergen, who returns the ball to Granados. Looks to play into the midfield, not able to find feet. Where Angel for the Marlins is able to collect, trying to slip Arujo in behind, unable to. Granados, the fresh left back with some good defense again. Bit of a stretched game right here. That should be a Shen throw-in. Crawford is able to muscle Alexa off the ball. Ooh, tough no-call for Crawford. There it is. Referee was most likely looking for an advantage, but not able to give it. Number seven, Abby Alexa has to be careful for the Hornets, as she's already on a yellow card. Bit of a hard foul there and kicked the ball away. Hate to see this game get a red card, but she's looking for trouble with plays like that. Morris on the ball, Pedicure defending. Looks to play a 1-2, but didn't spin off. Crawford able to receive. Pedicure in a bit of space here on her preferred right foot. Meinhard is checking. Finds Meinhard back to goal, who clips the ball cheekily around the corner to Arujo. Looks like it's going to be a corner kick. Well defended by Granados. With about 8.5 here, the Marlins have a corner kick. Interesting that the Shenandoah Hornets have still left their leading goal scorer, Emily Juergen, as a deep-lying center back and have not moved her back up the field. They seem pretty reluctant to put her forward and trust her that she's really going to help the team in defending, and she has done a great job today. Ball in by Pettacurt. Flicked on, unable to win. Good defense by Shenandoah. Cleared out. Petticone is back wide. Petticone's going to try to get another cross in. Well defended. Tough to tell if number 19, Taylor Morris, cleared that ball because Petticone was on the ground or just to get it out of the mix. It appears that she cleared it just to get it out of the mix because she's not asking for it back as a player, as if you did for an injured player. Marlins take the throw and give it to Meinhard. Arujo with the cross. Trouble. Well caught by Emily Smith. Way to move her feet and catch that ball heading toward her back post, eliminating all the danger. She's had a great day in the pipes. Elects to go big. Punt bounces before half. We're 14. The goal scorer, Spazzini, gets a touch. After a Virginia Marlin deflection, it goes out for a throw-in. Shenandoah. Shenandoah goes down the line. Fisher in possession. Looks back. Marlins bench wants it to be theirs. Shenandoah bench expects it to be theirs. Hayward in possession. Throws the ball in to Meinhard. Meinhard back to goal. Looking to link up. Cuts through two defenders. Well played. In a bit of space here. Has Marley Hayward in front. Doesn't get the pass off where she is defended well by Marquette. Some hard work by Meinhard is able to win a Virginia Wesleyan free kick. This is a pretty advantageous position. Most likely a bit far to shoot from, but definitely a great position to get a ball in the box and try to get a flick. On the ball for the Marlins will be number 20, Kennedy Ann Anders. She was the one who had the game-winning goal with about 30 seconds remaining the first time these teams met, so I'm sure the Hornets are afraid of what she can do. Ball into the mix. Angel goes up, doesn't win the knockdown, but she's able to receive. Ball pops out towards the frame. Fantastic goalkeeping by Smith. Quick off her line again. Collects, no questions asked. Just over five remaining in this 1-1 draw. ODAC quarterfinal. Both teams looking to advance to play the winner of Ferrum and Washington and Lee. That game is most likely already ended. Unsure of who is victorious, but whoever was will be watching this, eagerly awaiting the winner. Foul by the Marlins. Again, advantageous position here for the Hornets. Piers number 9 will be on the ball, or 20, both going at it. Maybe a quick free kick. Nope, not a quick free kick. They'll be loading the box up with 20 on the ball. That's Abby Marquette looking to put a dangerous ball in against the Marlins. Haven't had to defend with a lot of balls, but here it comes. Alexa's able to get the first flick. Ball's bouncing around. Alexa with another touch. Shenandoah turns. Clearance blocked. Morris on the sideline. Cleared by Shea Gary. The senior is everywhere. Very dangerous play there for the Hornets, creating some bounces. Third substitution of the day for the Hornets.
Now in for the Hornets, number 18, Maya Pensiel.
Maya Pensiel will be re-entering. Leading assist on the team, Maya Pensiel, is only a sophomore, re-enters the game. We'll be expect to see her in an attacking position, whether it's a forward midfielder or a true striker. Marlon's able to win the ball in the corner, try to clear it out, unable to get it. Goalkeeper comes, spills it, but Kakar is able to get back on top of it. Whew, some dicey moments back there for the Marlins. But bend but not break seems to be the motto for the night. Didn't break, able to collect the ball, punt big, and they're out of it. Not able to get the first touch. Shenandoah is. Get it to touch. And tough battle in the midfield. Ends up getting with Meinhard. Meinhard has Kearns down the sideline. Virginia Wesleyan with a sub that went unnoticed by the press box, it appears, because we did not announce her, but Kearns is on the field. She has appeared to have taken Reyna Arujo off and will be playing the left wing, but she just got over to the right in that one play. Pensiel on the ball, muscled off by Crawford. Crawford's got to get it off her foot, blocked well in the midfield by Shenandoah. Big ball. Meinhard with a bit of space here to run into. She's matched up against number 20, Abby Marquette. Muscled off, well defended. Hayward got a touch, not able to clear. Not able to sustain the pressure, my mistake. Hayward goes to play it back. That might be off Marley Hayward. Doesn't. Went to pick up the ball to try to trick the officials, but good call. It should be a Shenandoah throw-in. Morris throws the ball forward towards Alexa. Wins the initial header. Hayward and Morris get into it. Well tackled. Petticone receives the ball, able to slow it down a little. Hayward is still down, slow to get up. Petticone is driving. Granados, the substitute on the left, clips the ball forward where she finds Alexa in some space in a pocket. In a 1v1 battle with Crawford, Crawford has had her number this second half. Anders looks to play the ball forward to the sub, Kearns. Put some pressure on the right back, Morris knocks the ball out for a throw-in, will be a Marlins throw-in. Meinhardt on the ball, looking to turn. Not able to get it off, definitely looking to get a shot on her right. Referee blows the whistle, and that's a foul. Can't be more than 21 yards out. Let's see who gets the ball for the Marlins. You have to think this is a shooting position. One, two, three, four, five, six. Looks to be about six in the wall for the Hornets. Referee counts off 10. Only a righty on the ball, so not likely to go on the wall side. Ball's hit. Good contact, great save. That was Kennedy Anders with a great hit, but Emily Smith, the goalkeeper, up for the task and makes a great save to keep her team alive. Surely a goal at this point would end it. Kearns, the lefty on the ball, so now we have an in-swinger going towards the frame. We haven't had one of those all day. Let's see if it puts any change in the Marlins corner. Ball into the box. Angel is in space, gets the header! And Angel is able to get on the end of it with 1:08 to go. Wow. The in-swinging corner finds Angel in a bit of space at the top of the six where she's able to knock in the header. That's 32, Allie Angel, the senior. You gotta think the Hornets will be going big on this play and putting a lot of pressure for the last 1:08. Ball's clipped forward and we're underway. Minute to go, just over 1 minute. Meinhardt looking to probably clip the ball forward and hold it in the corner. In no rush. Earns the throw-in for the Marlins.
Marlins goal scored by number 32, Allie Angel.
Coach Bowers is saying everything forward, everything forward. Throws the ball to Angel. Angel's able to turn, kicks it towards the corner. They won't care about possession. All they want to do is see this 40 seconds out. Well shielded out for a goal kick. 35 on the clock. Big ball towards half. Heads up play by Petticone to let the goal kick out for a throw-in. Marlins throw-in with 20 seconds remaining in the match. Petticone takes it, releases the ball forward. Flicked on by Meinhard. Hayward putting a bit of pressure towards Angel. 10 seconds remaining. Arujo down the left flank. All she has to do is run to the corner. She gets it in the box, and that should surely do it. After an extremely hard-fought match, it ends 2-1 for the Virginia Wesleyan Marlins on a late corner kick goal with just over 1 minute remaining by Allie Angel, the senior. Both teams, great game, hard-fought match.